The big story has been the cool down today. 66 the high yesterday. Believe it or not, our high today in Lafayette was 52 degrees. Yeah, but that occurred very early in the morning, probably when you were sleeping, and temperatures have cooled down really all day today. And here's why. Here's this storm system that brought a lot of snowfall to our northwest. The cold front end of it has pushed off to the east, and that's really bringing in this cooler air. And in fact, 66 yesterday, flurries this evening. I walked outside just a little bit ago and we had flurries flying around, not really showing up here on the local view of the radar, but you do see a little bit of blue speckles and pink speckles indicating a little light sprinkle or maybe a little light flurry possible for the rest of the overnight hours. Now, right now on Renaissance Cam, things are quiet. We're still under the overcast skies and temperatures. Yeah, pretty chilly too. 33 degrees right now in Lafayette. There are the overcast skies. Also, pay attention to the wind. Wind out of the west, 10 miles per hour. Gusts have been as high as 20 to 25 miles per hour, and we'll contend with this pretty strong wind for the rest of the overnight hours out of the west, 10 to 15 miles per hour, gust slightly higher at times. Futurecast is going to hold on to the overcast conditions for the rest of the overnight hours into tomorrow morning as well. Also, possibility of a few flurries very early tomorrow morning, and then another round possible as we get into Tuesday evening. Here we are, Futurecast Tuesday evening. Notice some flurries popping up in parts of eastern Illinois. Now, before we get there, our temperatures overnight will drop into the middle to upper 20s for lows by tomorrow morning, going to 28 degrees in Lafayette, 27 in Monticello. We'll go to 26 up in Winnemac, and your day tomorrow, you know, not looking too bad, but it is cooler than average, but we'll stay mostly dry for really the entire day. Again, maybe a flurry or two in the early morning hours, right around 30 for 9, 35 degrees by noon. Again, still pretty breezy out of the west, 10 to 20 miles per hour, and 41 degrees the high tomorrow. And the clouds should break up towards the evening, only to be replaced with overcast skies for the overnight hours on Tuesday into early Wednesday. And again, maybe a few flurries. Not a big deal as we get into Wednesday. In fact, once we get past Wednesday morning into Wednesday evening and Thursday morning, we will start to clear skies out a little bit, going mostly clear to partly cloudy by Wednesday night. Overnight tonight, you know, pretty chilly night, 28 degrees overnight, cloudy, breezy. Those conditions stay with us through the early part of tomorrow morning. Don't be surprised if you see a few flurries tomorrow morning as well. Again, not a big deal. 37 degrees the high on Wednesday, 42 on Thursday. Yeah, baby, we make improvements on Friday with a high of 53 degrees. And then there comes the rain again next weekend. Saturday, a high of 49, 41 on Sunday, Monday, 41 as well. You know, it models all over the place on next week, but one thing looks for certain, it's going to be an active pattern. Temperature-wise, we're going to go with the cooler end of the models because one of the more trustworthy models has us there, and I think that looks good.
Okay, well, but still, it's not bad. I mean, compared to where we were a few weeks ago.
Yeah, we had the big time snowfall in March, our most significant of the year, and this is nothing.
Okay, sounds good. Thanks, Jesse.